do the words. James chapter 1, verses 21 to 25. Therefore, lay aside all filthiness and overflow of wickedness, and receive with meekness the implanted word, which is able to save your souls. But be doers of the word, and not hearers only, deceiving yourselves. For if anyone is a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like a man observing his natural face in a mirror. For he observes himself, goes away, and immediately forgets what kind of man he was. But he who looks into the perfect law of liberty and continues in it, and is not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this one will be blessed in what he does. This week, we're talking about having the Word of God abiding in us. The importance of letting the Word of Christ dwell in us richly, fill our beings. And as we said, the word abide means to be alive, to be living. And it also means to dwell, to remain, to reside. So it's alive and it's there permanently. And he says, let the word abide in you. So James tells us in the passage we read today that with meekness we receive the engrafted word. That means God's word becomes part of us. It becomes implanted in us. It's an engrafted word. It should become part of who we are. It becomes us. It fills our being. So he says, receive with humility the engrafted word, which is able to save your soul. It transforms your being. It brings about change in you. It transforms your soul, your mind, your will, your emotions, your thinking patterns, and your affections, and all of that. That word brings about that change inside you. But then he tells us something more important. He says, but in as much as you receive this word, remember to be a doer of the word. Otherwise, you're like a man who looks at himself in the mirror, and then he forgets what kind of a man he was. He forgets his identity. He forgets who he really is, and he goes and behaves like somebody else. So if I hear the word, but I don't do the word, then I live far short of who God wants me to be, the kind of life God wants me to live, and far short of my real identity in God. So I hear the word, but that you and I must go and live by that word, then we are living according to our true identity in God. And then he also adds, he says, look, if you're a doer of the word, you will be blessed in everything you do. You'll be blessed in what he does. Whatever you do, you will be blessed, is what James says. This one will be blessed in what he does. So hearing the word, receiving that word, letting that word abide in you, be implanted in you, be impregnated in you. And then that word becomes your identity when you do that word, and that word becomes a source of your blessing when you act on it. So remember, be a doer of the word. It defines your, describes your identity. It brings blessing in all that you do. You're blessed when you act on the word. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, and then live by that word. Stay aground, firm, make your decisions based on the word. Act on that word. Let the word of God guide you. You will see blessing in all you do. Let's pray. Father, we ask that we will let the word of Christ dwell in us richly, and that God, we will be doers of your word. And we will live by your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.